Hey everyone, Chimera45 here. Welcome back to Let's Play God of War 2 Titan Mode. Last time, we fought our way through more creatures of the temple, and this time, we're going to be doing even more of that. So here we have a little section that's not difficult to master, not difficult to figure out or anything. Just gets annoying with all of the enemy ambushes that you have to put up with. But I'm pretty sure you can apply that to almost any scenario in God of War. So, can't really blame me for saying that, I guess. Alright, so what you gotta do is you gotta stand on this thing, wait for the vines to spread out, slow down time, and run across them. Simple as pie. Jump down here. What do we got? Phoenix feather. Good. Need to catch up on those. Yeah, you have to. You kind of have to go back over here if you go get that phoenix feather, because there's no time medallion thing over there. Or Statue of the Fates, whatever you want to call it. Not really sure if it has an official name or not. Then you come over here. Enemy ambush. Take advantage of the slowing down time thing. And you can take care of it. Pretty much no problem. Throw you over there. Slow down time again, rinse, cycle, repeat. And it's pretty much these same enemies over and over again. So, instead of talking about this, let's talk about something exciting. There are two movies coming out this month that I am going to be doing reviews on when I go see them because they look awesome. Logan and Kong Skull Island, they both look really good. And the new Power Rangers movie is coming out this month. I have no interest in seeing that. If I can find a way to watch it somehow, like, I don't know. sorry about that. Or something like that. Maybe I'll watch it and tell you guys what I think about it. But for the most part, I have no interest in seeing it. I loved Power Rangers when I was a kid. I have no shame in saying that, and even to this day, if I saw like one of the older shows on and I was nothing else to watch on TV, I would probably put it on and I would probably laugh at it for the most part, but I would still enjoy it because they were just good shows to watch. To just, you know, they were going to be goofy, you know, they weren't going to be realistic, so it was just one of those things you could watch and just enjoy the hilarity and the insanity, you know what I mean? It was just one of those kind of shows. This movie, they're just trying to make them all serious and trying to they're just trying to make it Hollywood, you know? The suits look like they're from Iron Man. It's just not cool. Oh, alright, here's something interesting in the game. Another boss battle. We're getting through a lot of boss battles.
That door was my only escape. I have faced test after test in search of the sisters. And now you have dashed it all away. You certainly do not live up to your reputation, Ghost of Sparta. But perhaps this is a test. Are you watching me now, sisters? Give me a sign! Am I, the great Perseus, to kill this fallen god to receive an audience with you? Will that allow me to bring my love back from the grasp of Hades himself? If not, at least I can bathe in the glory of being the one who brought down the mighty Kratos, the slayer of gods. Although I hardly think a harpy's fool such as yourself deserves such praise.
All right, so this arrogant prick is Perseus, the guy from mythology who originally killed Medusa. We took that honor from him in the first game. And he is here to seek an audience with the sisters to revive his love Andromeda, who died. He probably didn't save her from the Hydra because he didn't have Medusa's head in order to stop the Hydra. So that's probably what happened. Or no, not the Hydra. It was just some sea serpent type thing. But anyway, in this game, he has three modes, I guess you could call them. The helmet, where he is invisible, and you kind of just have to swing your blades and hope for the best. There are sometimes you can see him like in the water right there, like you can see his footsteps, but then he'll jump, and you have no idea where he'll be. But then he'll start firing his little slingshots at you, and you can reflect them back at him, and they will do a little bit of damage. I usually wait until I see the footprints, like, run right up on me, and then that's when I'll attack. He's not the most difficult boss in this game, by far, but he can be a little tricky, especially in this first mode. Once you get out of this first mode, it's not that bad. This first mode is definitely the tricky one. Mostly because you can't see him. If you could see him, it'd be no problem. But since we cannot see him, nothing but problems.
I'm over here now!
Sorry, I'm listening. Can't tell if someone's here or if that's the landlord.
I'm over here.
I think that's the landlord. I'm not entirely sure. Let's see if I can pull this off successfully. Alright, so there we go. We got the helmet from him, and I checked to make sure, and that yes, that is just my landlord. And now we are on to the second part of the fight. Here he will use his sword and his shield, but like I said, now that we can actually see him, it is not that difficult. I sure hope I didn't miss a death here, because I have, like, no health. And I just find it very hard to believe that I beat him with that little sliver of health. Although, I guess it's possible. And if I do, I'll feel pretty damn proud of myself. As you can see, his shield, when cast into or when reflecting sunlight, can amplify it greatly. And Myth, his shield had a mirror on the inside, because Medusa's gaze won't freeze you if you look at it through a mirror. And his sword was sharp enough to cut through her scales, which were otherwise unbreakable. Alright, so I guess I do it with just a little sliver of health. That's pretty cool. When he loses his shield, he pretty much has nothing to use except... Or when he loses his sword, I'm sorry. He pretty much has nothing to use but his shield and his slingshot. I mean, he can bash you with his shield. I kind of wish they had given him, like, a Captain America thing where he threw the shield at you and it would come back to him. That would have been cool and funny at the same time. Not saying like have him throw it on the wall and bounce it at you. Just a simple little throw at you, I think would have been cool. He'll continue to use that blinding effect. But we always manage to break out of it before he can do anything about it. And as you see, hitting him against the wall there, it kind of stunned him. So you can use that to your advantage. No, none of that. So like I said, overall, this fight isn't the most difficult. in the whole game. It's probably one of the easiest boss fights, honestly. But that first stage, where you can't see him, does get a little tricky. As evidence, where he got me down to this little sliver of health while he was invisible. And then after that, he got me a few times with his sword. But for the most part, he did all that damage to me when he was invisible. Alright, when he starts backing up all the way like that, you pretty much have got him near death. And you just have to hit him a few times, and then he will go down into a circle prompt, which should happen any second now. Reflect that back at him, hit him a few times. Come on, buddy. I was cutting it so close. There we go. I was cutting so close there, though. And Perseus is dead. Bye-bye, Perseus. Nice knowing you, buddy. Not really. You're a kind of an arrogant prick. So now we have the shield of Perseus, which would have been redundant if they let you keep that, because we already have a shield. We have our badass golden fleece, and there's nothing to explore in here, so go back outside. Whee! Now that we have that shield, we can give it to her. See what I mean? Prep work. As soon as we killed him, do all this. I don't know why I felt the need to do that. You could honestly put it even closer to you. And then jump to it from there. But whatever. So what you do is you raise her up until she's reflecting one beam. And then you jump up here as quickly as you can. Over here. And then you reflect. Oh. Damn it. Epic fail. So you come up here, and you reflect the second beam with the golden fleece, which I think is pretty cool. There we go. Barrier number two, out of our way. Handled pretty well, I think. You can come over here and you can investigate Perseus's corpse. Doesn't say anything, though. Obviously, the corpse doesn't say anything. I meant, like, no text prompts pop up or anything like that. Man, I recorded like 4 or 5 videos back to back to back. My voice is starting to get a little rough. So I apologize for that.
How about I try to talk really, really low for you guys for a while? Would you be okay with me talking like this all day long? Or would you rather me talk like this all day long?
I don't know. When I talk for a long time, I start to talk about and get really weird, so... Talk about weird things and start being really weird, so I apologize for that. That's why I tend not to talk much. I don't like being weird. Like, there's that one commercial. Like, it's fine being weird. Like, that's what, like, the title of it is called or something. And it's just, it's stupid. It is fine being weird. Like, there's nothing wrong with being weird. Or, you know, unique, or whatever you want to call it. But you don't have to make a whole song out of it. And again, you don't have to make songs out of a lot of things that are made into songs. You recognize this thing? This is that dark griffin that the rider was on earlier that was attacking us. And now we have his Spear of Destiny. which I think they drew inspiration from Christian, from like Christian Bible for this. I think it's like based off the spear like that was used to stab Jesus or something, I think. I don't really know. I'm not a Bible student, so I don't really know if that happened or not. I thought I saw like on an info prompt for this. I don't know why I keep saying prompt. On an info page for this spear, I thought it said down below, like, you know, those little notes areas, that it was based off of a spear that stabbed Jesus or something like that. So I thought that was a little weird that they put that into a Greek game, but whatever. Nothing wrong with incorporating all aspects of mythologies and religions and all that. Alright, so you, I have a problem with. Your current position, not where you need to be. Not even close. But first, I need your assistance with something. Well, yes. I go ahead and I get her into the proper position that I need right now, but... Oh, do I not? No. Well, because I'm being dumb again. Yes, that is how you want her to be right there, but you also... Yeah, I'm being dumb because... Alright. So yeah, like I said, you can get her into that right position right there, but you want to take her down here first, because we need her assistance. I don't know why I'm being so stubborn. Yeah, because this isn't going to work. It's not gonna work like that. You literally have to bring her down there. Oh, jeez. Okay, sorry about that. I had to go open the door for my cousin real quick. Alright, so yeah, like I said, we have to bring the statue down here with us instead of being stubborn and trying to keep it up there. And then we do that. We come over here. And we hurry. And we still don't make it. What? But I thought that's what you had to do. That is what you have to do. Guess I just wasn't fast. Oh, no. I'm being dumb again. You do it from over here. There we go. Yeah, like I said. I can be very dumb sometimes. Maybe it's a good thing my cousin showed up, because I really can't keep up all this talking much longer. I got through quite a few number of episodes today, though. So, hopefully tomorrow, we'll be able to finish this up. Yes, that's definitely worth the effort to get into that room. Because that Gorgon Eye Phoenix Feather are good, but that Urn of Olympus... If you want to get all the urns, that's definitely one that you need to get then. Because I'm starting to rant, I'm starting to blabber. Starting to not make sense. Yeah, definitely time to call it for a day. Recorded 3 yesterday, recorded like 4 or 5 today. I think 4. And I have to record the rest tomorrow. I have to. Even if they all don't get posted by the 28th, I at least have to have them recorded before then. So I can focus all my attention on that new game. That new game looks so good. I've avoided looking at as much as possible
So I could go into a completely blind. But, of course, I looked at the trailers for it, but I didn't look at, like, the in-length trailers. I wanted to get the collector's edition for it, but by the time I went to pre-order, all the collector's editions were taken. There might be a chance. Might be a chance that I can get one if someone doesn't come and get it. But aside from that, it's not gonna happen. Alright, so this is one of my favorite sections in God of War. It probably is like my favorite platform section in the entire series. I don't know why, but like the first time I played this, it was just so epic and intense, just seeing all the platforms falling in the background, having to time your jumps right in order to get across it. Like, it was just overall, like, just really epic to me, and I enjoyed the hell out of it. And I remember when I played through it the second time, I made a save specifically before this so I could play it whenever I felt like it. And in retrospect, it's not that great. You know, it's really not that impressive or that lengthy, but just from the time, like when I was first getting into video games, I was just like, oh, that was so epic. Alright, this little section gave me a bit of difficulty. I'm not gonna lie. These bitches know how to hand Kratos' ass. And not in a good way. They can create those little torrents of electricity that stun you, and they can throw their little orbs at you. I don't remember. Is this the first time we've encountered them? I think so. Whenever it does like a cutscene like that, it's usually the first time we've encountered that type of enemy. Man, I apologize. My voice is really starting to get strained here. I don't know how people can talk for hours and hours and hours on end. I guess it's like any muscle after you work it for a long time. It just gets stronger. I guess it's the same for your vocal cords. Alright, these two on their own, I can handle. These two with those sirens with you, that is something I could not handle. So that's why I tried to kill those sirens as quickly as possible. Because these guys aren't that bad if you can get your blocks in. These guys are like the juggernauts. They look big and intimidating, but they really don't take too much to take down. And a little bit of luck thrown in there does not hurt one bit. Because I will admit, I got very lucky in quite a few parts. And this is the whole playthrough, like not just this game, but like the whole series in general, during these very hard difficulty playthroughs. Alright, one down. Oh sweet, two down. What's not sweet though, is even after you get through this section, there's another section, and I think another section after that. And if you die on the third section to like the last enemy, you have to start all over again. Oh boy, let me tell you how much I enjoyed that when I found out. Cause I don't think I had like, I'm sure I died in this section before, but I never paid it any mind because I wasn't on the hardest difficulty. But after having to play through this about 20 times, yeah, it got some. These playthroughs, these Titan mode playthroughs, or whatever you want to call them, they're taking years off of my life. They really are. All the mental stress of trying to kill these things, it's really taking its toll. Getting gray hair already. I'm not even done. Still one more game. Because I highly doubt I'm going to do Ascension. I highly doubt it. I consider Ascension like a spin-off game, kinda. Because it doesn't really fit with the rest of God of War. even like the story of it doesn't really make much sense. Alright, buddy, I have like no health, so you are getting the circle treatment. That's my new term for it, the circle treatment. Luckily, he was already damaged enough that it didn't take too long to kill him. But oh boy. Of course, there is a second one. This might get a little redundant, so I might just... I don't know if I'll cut this or not. I guess it depends on how many it takes to kill him. Yeah, I'm just gonna cut this, I think. There we go. So after quite a few impales through his stomach, we finally managed to decapitate him. Oh, okay. And this video is over. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time for more God of War 2 Titan Mode. I will see you then.